Hi, Bartosz here from Cyrus. In this video, myself, Nick and Chris are going to talk about the PSU XR, our new power supply designed to complement the XR product range. High quality power supply is of key importance for premium audio products, which is why at Cyrus we have always taken power supply very seriously. After all, one of our earliest products nearly 40 years ago was an outboard power supply, the original PSX. Since then, we have made a lot of progress, which you can find in the latest iteration of that original concept, the PSX R2, the power supply designed to work with the classic range. There are a number of videos on our YouTube channel discussing how it can be used to improve the performance of the classic series. Do check them out if you're interested. You can find the link to the playlist including all those videos in the upper right-hand corner of your screen now. So the PSX R2 is already a great improvement over the original PSX. It has an adaptive analog power tracking system that responds to the needs of the host product. How this works in practice is that the host product, be it a CD player, amplifier, phono stage, or any other compatible product, sends a request to the PSX R2 in the form of a reference voltage, and the PSX R2 delivers back to the host product a cleaner and significantly more stable supply at 10 times that reference voltage. The host then uses this to supply power to the sections of the product that benefit most from the cleaner and more robust power source. Unlike many of our competitors who also offer multiple upgraded PSUs for each of their products, the same single model of PSX R2 can be used on all compatible classic products. With the PSU XR, we have taken this thinking to a whole new level. Firstly, the PSU XR is the first power supply from Cyrus that is controlled by a microprocessor. It might also be the world's first outboard power supply with such an intelligent design. It is unbelievably flexible as it optimizes the operating current and voltage conditions for each circuit to perform at its best. The PSU XR literally talks to the host product and provides it with the best configuration of power sources. While the PSX R2 is a fully regulated power supply, the PSU XR, if asked to do so, can also output unregulated power as one of its three voltages, which especially benefits power amplifier sections. In this mode, the PSU XR will work jointly with the host product's internal power supply to vastly improve the burst current performance. This can be observed especially on fast transients. While the PSX R2 is a massive upgrade in its own right, one of its limitations is that it amplifies the input to reference voltage together with any artifacts present in it, including noise. By contrast, the output voltages from the PSU XR are all digitally synthesized, so are therefore extremely stable and virtually noise-free. This will have a massive impact on the overall sonic performance. The PSU XR has 5 different power supply circuits and can at any time provide 3 different reference voltages to the host product, as opposed to only one in the case of the PSX R2. This means it can work with more circuits in the host product and the impact is far greater.
The most impressive part of the design is that all the power supply circuits are completely separate. There is no common ground inside the PSU XR, preventing any noise transfer between them. One other advantage of separating those power supplies is that current demands on one supply will not affect the stability of other supplies. So the grounds are only connected inside the host product. To handle all this functionality and flexibility, there is a 15-pin cable between the products as opposed to the 5-pin system in the classic range. The PSU XR is capable of delivering up to 60% more power than the classic PSXR2 and, due to its clever design, is up to 50% more efficient. It actually uses the largest transformer ever seen in a Cyrus. The transformer used in the PSU XR is actually 20% larger compared to the one used in the PSXR2. As with the PSXR2, we only have one model of the PSU XR because it can be used with any compatible XR product. Also, the PSU XR is future-proof as it is designed to work with products that do not even exist yet. When the new products in the XR series are launched, only a simple software update will be needed for the PSU XR to be compatible with them. So it is a safe investment for the years to come. The focus on power doesn't stop here. Within the individual XR products, higher specification components provide much stiffer power supply circuits. Each product has multiple internal power circuits completely separated and designed that wherever grounds meet, which they must, there's negligible current flow. This separation hugely reduces the potential for any noise to be carried by power supplies around the product. The new PSU XR currently works with the following XR products: i9 XR, Pre-XR, CDI-XR, and CDT-XR. But as mentioned before, it is designed to be future-proof. It already has the hooks in place for future products planned for the XR series, including the BlueOS streamer, currently scheduled for 2023. This power supply is very easy to set up, but you must make sure that the host products are running the latest firmware version because otherwise they will not communicate with the PSU XR. Then all you need to do is connect the mains and use the supplied 15-pin cable to connect it to the host product. Please also remember to do up the retaining screws. No other user configuration or setup is required. The PSU XR and host products handle it all for you.
Let us now look at how the PSU XR improves the performance of the specific connected host products. On the i9 XR, the PSU XR and the internal power supply combine to power the power amp section. This further stiffens the main power supply rails to the amplifier, meaning that the amplified signal can more accurately track the input signal. You hear this accuracy in the music, which becomes more transparent and more detailed. The preamp section is completely driven by the PSU XR. Again, this means a stiffer supply, leading to greater accuracy. This leaves the internal power supply to run the DAC section. And because it is now doing less work, the supply it can provide to the DAC is more robust. In our listening tests, we observed a massive improvement on the i9 XR. We got more weight, more authority, better detail, better attack, and overall better control of rise and fall of notes and more accurate timing. On the pre-XR, the PSU XR takes over power in the preamp side, leaving the digital section to be powered by the internal supply. This combination works particularly well here as the internal transformer has been custom designed to power small signal circuitry exclusively. Sonically, you may observe a bit more authority on the low end registers, better attack on the notes, which translates into improved imaging and instruments sounding more real. On the CD players, the PSU XR powers the master clock. This helps improve jitter. The PSU XR also powers the CD motors. This is, electrically speaking, a very noisy circuit as the motors are constantly changing velocity. Taking this supply outside the box lowers the overall noise within the box, helping the player to perform even more accurately. In the CDI XR, the PSU XR also takes over power in the analog side of the DAC, with the internal supply powering the digital side of the DAC. Again, this separation of power supplies helps to limit the transfer of noise. The step up in performance may be noticed most on the CDI XR, as it also has a DAC section built in. Sonically, we get improved timing, better control of bass notes, more accurate edges, and control of notes and enhanced imagery. We hope that we have given you an insight into the new PSU XR, but as always, we encourage you to hear the improvements for yourself. So booking a demo at your local retailer is the next step in discovering the power of the PSU XR. That's it for now. Thanks very much. Bye.